Dickinson College's Alliance for Aquatic Resource Monitoring, ALARM, engages volunteers to monitor their local waterways. Using water quality data, communities are able to learn more about the health of local streams. In today's video, we will be teaching you how to conduct a nitrate-nitrogen test on your water sample. Nitrate-nitrogen is a vital nutrient for aquatic biota. However, in excess, it can be problematic. Background levels of nitrate in streams is 1 part per million, or 1 milligram per liter. Stream Team tests streams for nitrate to establish a baseline understanding of nutrients in your waterways. Thank you for safely collecting a water sample and transporting it to your testing location in a cooler with an ice pack. For measuring your sample's nitrate-nitrogen values, you will need to test your sample within 48 hours of collection, a beaker, a syringe, the Lamott Tracer pocket tester, 2 test tubes, nitrate number 1 and nitrate number 2 tablets, a timer, the OctaSlide viewer and color range bar, a designated liquid waste bin, and a white sheet of paper. To begin your nitrate-nitrogen test, invert the sample water 3 times to make sure the sample is mixed. It is important to note that your water sample must be at room temperature prior to testing it for nitrate-nitrogen. This is between the temperatures 20 to 23 degrees Celsius. You can test for temperature with your Lamott Tracer pocket tester. The reading will show in the bottom right corner of the meter's screen. To achieve room temperature, we suggest testing nitrate last of your 3 post-stream tests. If your water sample is too cold, leave it out. You can also warm a small portion of the sample in a beaker between your hands or place it in a bowl of warm water while being sure to continuously stir the sample with your meter so you can check the temperature while warming. If the temperature goes above the range, fill the beaker again with the original sample water. Once you receive your temperature reading, turn the Lamott Tracer pocket tester off, rinse the electrode with distilled water, and shake to dry. Replace the gray electrode cap, and mark your data sheet that you have checked the sample's temperature prior to testing. Now, you can use the syringe to fill both test tubes with 5 milliliters of sample water. Using the syringe allows for higher precision in regards to the water's volume. You may get air bubbles in the syringe or draw more than 5 milliliters of water. To remove air bubbles and excess water, invert the syringe and tap it while gently depressing its plunger. Do this over your liquid waste container. Do not return excess water into the original sample collection bottle to avoid contamination of any kind. You can now transfer the water from your syringe into your test tube. Next, add the nitrate number 1 tablet to the test tube and cap it. Shake the test tube until the tablet dissolves or nothing is visibly settled at the bottom. This can take about 30 seconds. Once your tablet is dissolved, add nitrate number 2 tablet to the test tube and cap it. Grab your timer and set the time for 2 minutes. Shake the test tube continuously to dissolve the tablet. Try to shake in a consistent manner for 2 minutes. You can also run your 2 replicates simultaneously. If you choose to do this, hold and shake both test tubes in the same hand for consistency. Once the 2 minutes are up, put the samples down and set the timer for 5 minutes and wait for the reaction to finish. Now is a great time to review the averaging of replicates. Values on the color slider are represented by a printed number or by the thick black line exactly halfway between the printed numbers. For instance, 1.0 and 2.0 are printed, and the black line in between these two values represents the value 1.5. A helpful tip when averaging replicates is to always round up or down to the nearest value available on the color slider. For instance, if your average comes out to 1.75, that value is not represented by either 1.0, 1.5, or 2.0, and should be rounded up to 2.0 for precision's sake. Now that you have let your sample sit for 5 minutes, insert one test tube into the OctaSlide color range viewer. Hold the viewer about 1 foot in front of a white colored background and have a good light source above and behind the back of the viewer. You can also hold a white sheet of paper about 1 foot from the OctaSlide viewer for another source of light. Match the color in the test tube to the color most similar on the OctaSlide bar and record the result on your data sheet as value, milligrams per liter, nitrate, nitrogen. If the color is between two values, you can record the midpoint between the two values. If you are having difficulty determining what color matches your sample best, it is helpful to ask another person what color they are seeing by having each person write down their value and then discussing. Also, the colors are on a saturation scale, so actively think about how concentrated the sample looks with the light pink reagent. If you choose to test each replicate individually, repeat the process using the second test tube. If you do not have a clean test tube available, be sure to clean your glassware the same way you would when done with testing. The values of the two replicates must be within the acceptable precision range. If the values are outside of the range, run an additional replicate until the two values are within range. Use only the two replicate values within the acceptable range to calculate the average value. Then, record the results on your data sheet. When you are done, pour the water from both test tubes into your waste container or down the sink with running water. Next, be sure to wash your testing equipment accordingly. Check out our acid washing video to recall this procedure. Congratulations! You have completed nitrate-nitrogen testing. We hope this video has been helpful.
Thank you for watching and volunteering to assess the health of your stream. We appreciate your investment in your local waterways.